Hey, Tori here with ToriTote.com, the place to be to create a home. Buyers, or anyone for that matter, will find irresistible. Well, welcome to our Christmas Carol DIY collab. This one's going to be a fun one, guys, and there are tons of YouTubers participating, so make sure that you follow the other videos on this playlist. So, here's what we have to do. Come up with our favorite Christmas carol, which for me, I like a lot of them, but my favorite is this one.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful.
Okay, so here's what I decided to do. I wanted to do a kind of like a wooden sign. So I'll show you the big piece of wood that I actually got. It's pretty big. It's like bigger than my body. Right? Check that out. Awesome, right? So I found this at Michael's, and I'm gonna make a Christmas sign out of it saying, "Let it snow." But rather than just have the words on the wood, I wanted to make it a little bit more 3D and festive. So I found this guy too at Michael's, kind of expensive, $15, but I can always take him off the sign if I decide not to use this in coming years. And do something else with it. So I loved this piece, so I'm going to put that on it as well. But let me show you the other things that you're going to need for this DIY project. So I picked up some newspaper to put on my table just to make sure that I don't get that dirty as I'm doing the project. I'm gonna be painting the wood a light blue. So I have two parts white to blue. As you can see, the white, you want more white than blue. Obviously I want it to be a light blue. If you wanted to go darker, then you would use more blue to white, just so you guys know that. I think I might use these somehow, so stay tuned. And I also found some cute little silver and gold snowflakes that I could attach to the sign as well. Of course, I need my foam brushes so I can easily put the paint on, and I've got some stencils here as well to do the saying, "Let it snow," and just a little small cup of water here in case I need it. So let's get started. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix the paint pretty lightly here. Just start making the color that I want. It's a little thick, so the water's really gonna help me here. And I just wanna make it like a light, you know, wintry type blue. All right, so perfect. We have a nice thin layer on here. As I told you before, you're gonna be able to still see the wood grains. You could still see some of the knots in here, so you could tell that this is actually a wood sign. So as our blue paint dries on the wood, I wanted to take an extra step here and make our Christmas tree a little bit more lifelike. So I'm gonna use these fake evergreen stems right here, and I love them because they even have the white balls on it, so it looks like fresh snow. Our fake evergreen on the Christmas tree wood, I'm going to want to attach this to the blue sign, and I'm going to do that with some wood glue. Are you on the naughty list? So while I'm waiting for the Christmas tree to dry on the wooden sign, I'm gonna start stenciling, and I'm gonna be very careful. Now you may wanna actually outline the stencils with a pencil so you know that it's all gonna fit.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping, and I've brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low.
Of course, last but not least is to add just a few snowflakes to refer back to the saying here, "Let it snow." There you have it. We have created our very own DIY gigantic wood sign that says, "Let it snow." Again, this resembles that Christmas carol, "Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow." And of course, to see all our Christmas carol DIY collabs, make sure you stay tuned to this playlist right here. And until next time, happy DIYing.